Hi there, my name's Kristen from HURIDOCS, and today I'm here to talk to you about Uwazi. Uwazi is a flexible database application that we've developed for human rights defenders who need to capture and organize collections of information. In practice, this means human rights defenders are using Uwazi to preserve evidence of human rights violations, organize libraries of human rights law, build collective memories in the pursuit of transitional justice, and more. We originally designed Uwazi as a solution for human rights defenders who work with jurisprudence. It was difficult for them to find what they needed in collections of court rulings when these court rulings came in the form of PDFs and Word documents. So in 2017, Uwazi was first released as a tool for document management. However, human rights defenders don't just work with PDFs and text documents. They also have to collect many other types of information like observations, geolocation points, multimedia fields, and many other data points. That's why, ever since its official launch, we've been working to expand what Uwazi can do. So, let me tell you what you can do with Uwazi. Uwazi makes it easy to create a collection of information even when the information comes in different formats. You can upload loose pieces of text, PDFs, Word documents, photos, videos, and other materials. You can do so one at a time or in bulk using CSV. Once you've added to your collection, you'll be able to browse all its contents in a few different formats, as cards, in a table, or on a map. You'll also be able to view documents and multimedia right in your browser without having to download anything. Now that you've created your collection in Uwazi, you can organize it however you need. So let me demonstrate this part for you. For each type of information in your collection, you can customize a template that will contain all the properties you will need. For example, let's say I have a template called Record of Incident, and I want to include properties such as date, location, and description. By dragging each type of property to the template, I can add and configure the properties I need for each type of information in my collection. You can also define the lists of terms available to be selected in any select or multi-select properties. In Uwazi, these lists are called thesauri. And you can change these templates, properties, and lists at any time. You can capture relationships between different types of information in your collection as well, such as the victim and perpetrator in relation to a record of incident. Now that you've organized its contents, you can explore your collection and glean insights from it in a few different ways. You can look at the different categories to see the total number of records that are labeled as such. You can select different combinations of categories to see which records match all of the chosen attributes. You can perform a search of a keyword or phrase, not only across the entire collection, but also within a specific record. And you can visualize selected data in a chart or a map. If the information in your collection is multilingual, that's not a problem. You can translate both the interface of Uwazi, as well as all the records within your collection. And you can translate this into more than one language, and this includes right-to-left languages like Arabic. And if you're working as part of a team, Uwazi has features to support this as well. You can assign different levels of permissions to different team members, individually or as a group, allowing them to edit a record or only view it. With Uwazi, you can also collaborate and share beyond just your team. You can receive information from outside Uwazi through submission forms. The entire collection itself can be entirely private, open to the public, or configured somewhere in between. And you can export information in the collection as a CSV file. I also want to talk to you about how Uwazi can help keep your information safe. Two-factor authentication protects your information from unintended users gaining access to the platform. Uwazi also has an activity log that allows for monitoring of any changes to the site. You can host your collection on your own server if that's what you prefer, or you can choose a secure hosting plan with HURIDOCS. And Uwazi is open source. We regularly audit the code for vulnerabilities. Now that I've explained the basic functionality of Uwazi, I want to share a few new ideas we're excited about. The first is using Uwazi to help preserve and archive digital content. In partnership with the Global Legal Action Network, we've developed an integration between Uwazi and an application called Digital Evidence Vault, developed by Enrique Pirasis. Digital Evidence Vault is a browser extension that the Global Legal Action Network is using to save a copy of digital evidence that shows airstrikes against civilians in Yemen. This extension captures online media and metadata according to standards that make it more likely to be admissible in court. Now, with this integration, all of that saved content is added to an Uwazi collection where Global Legal Action Network can more easily organize and see patterns within the information. Digital content is playing an increasingly important role in human rights investigation, so we hope this integration will be helpful for other projects as well. The second initiative is the integration of machine learning, which can lessen the burden on database administrators by automating certain tasks. For example, we worked with UPR Info to integrate machine learning algorithms into their database of UPR recommendations and voluntary pledges. These algorithms automatically extract certain content from source documents as well as make suggestions for how to categorize it. Work that used to take UPR Info staff a couple of months now takes a couple of weeks or less. Today, their database contains over 86,000 UPR recommendations. We're continuing to explore other ways that we could apply machine learning to help human rights defenders work more efficiently and effectively. So, what's next? We're exploring integrations with existing tools that can help our partners collect and protect information in low bandwidth environments. We're also expanding the options our partners have for how to structure their information in order to capture and analyze more complex data sets. In Swahili, Uwazi means openness, and it was based on this principle that Uwazi was born. Human rights groups deal with enormous amounts of data, accumulating years or even decades worth of facts and materials that support the case for change. However, without safe, efficient, and collaborative ways of managing it all, many of these insights contained in these collections will remain closed off to the very people who need them most. For more than 100 human rights projects, Uwazi has been a game changer. It has allowed them to organize a collection of information and in the process reveal previously hidden patterns, relationships, and opportunities for action. If you think that Uwazi could help you organize and use your human rights information in new ways, we invite you to learn more about Uwazi through our website and to get in touch. Thank you.